Okay, let's take a break from the world of lies coming to us from the White House about the virus. Let's look at science, all right? If you've been watching our show, you would already know about a bunch of possible treatments, not game changers the way Trump is saying. We're talking about possible coronavirus treatments. The question has mostly been, are these safe enough to use in proper clinical trials? And when might that start? The World Health Organization is starting an unprecedented quadruple clinical trial where doctors around the world can participate. This is called Solidarity. I don't know if that is an acronym for something. It may be, maybe not. This is basically taking what would often be a very long process and compressing it into simultaneous trials. They are not blinded trials. We'll talk about that in a second. And four different treatments are going to be tried. Because we have so many patients, you can try four different things at once compared to placebo and the standard treatment. In this case, they may not be using placebo. That may be unethical given the circumstances. Thousands of patients across multiple countries are going to be included. Now, this is being done both to consider these drugs as treatments for people who are already sick, but also with the possibility that maybe some of these could become prophylactics in advance of a vaccine to protect people from the virus. We don't know. That's what's being tested. All right. The four drugs being tested would be familiar to anyone who's been watching our show since I told you about these weeks ago. We've got the antiviral remdesivir. That's from Gilead Pharma, developed for Ebola, didn't work well for Ebola, going to be tested in this large WHO clinical trial. Number two, already spoke about it, chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine, another form of the same drug, around since 1934, used to treat malaria. Side effects can include muscle problems, loss of appetite, diarrhea, and skin rash. Serious side effects can include vision issues, muscle damage, seizures, low blood cell levels, which itself can lead to subsequent problems. Small test showed it worked on a small sample of coronavirus patients. It was not blinded and it was not randomized. Now there will be more testing done in combination with azithromycin. Number three, a combination of two HIV drugs, lopinavir and ritonavir. That's the third trial that's being done. And then lastly, the fourth test will be those two HIV drugs, lopinavir and ritonavir, with the addition of interferon beta. Doctors will be able to put their patients' information into a WHO computer system, see who's eligible for which test, account for underlying conditions, which may make someone not a good candidate for one test, but maybe an okay candidate for another. This is a massive major undertaking. This is the large trial that we've been waiting for, which starts this week. Now, of course, looking at already approved drugs, drugs approved for other things, is going to be the fastest path, much faster than developing new drugs for sure. But then in addition, they are also looking at adding trials of drugs that have not yet been approved, but that have worked well in animal trials on other types of respiratory viruses, MERS, SARS, et cetera. So as I mentioned, again, these are not double blind tests. Double blind would be neither the doctor nor the patient knows who's getting which treatment. The idea is you prevent a placebo effect. You prevent the doctor from consciously or subconsciously giving the trial treatment to patients that may be predisposed to do better anyway. That would skew the data. But still, this is the way it's being done. A number of medical ethicists, including our friend from NYU, Arthur Kaplan, say, given the circumstances, this is a good test. So as always, none of these things will give us answers as soon as we would like. The sooner you start, the sooner you get data, the sooner you can start to figure out whether one of these may be a good path forward. Sometimes when you do this, you will very quickly see one of these four treatments is significantly better than the standard treatment and significantly better than the other treatments that are being tested. When the results are overwhelming in these emergency situations, you will sometimes see the case made that you need to drastically expand giving patients the treatment that appears to be working. We just don't know yet. Then you have to start dealing with supply and distribution issues, all sorts of other things. those would be figured out. So that's the big trial going on, unprecedented quadruple clinical trial. We'll see what comes from it. Let's have realistic expectations. Make sure for more on these trials, follow the David Pakman Show on Instagram at David Pakman Show. While you're there, follow me on Instagram at David.Pakman to see what I've been up to during the self-quarantine. Privacy.com is one of our sponsors, and they're giving you $5 just for using their free service at privacy.com/Pakman. Privacy is a service I've been using for a while now. I love it. It saves me a bunch of headaches. It's completely free and it's very quick to set up. And here's how it works. When you pay for something online or over the phone, instead of exposing your real credit card number, Privacy lets you generate virtual card numbers. The payments are withdrawn from your checking account, but your real card number stays completely private, and you do it all with one click. You can autofill the card number in your web browser, on the phone. You can create 12 virtual cards a month. You can set spending limits, freeze them, delete them whenever you want. I especially love it for free trials where you need to give a credit card number, because I can destroy the virtual card number as soon as I give it to the company, and I know I won't be charged in the future. If you're ordering food over the phone, why do I need to give a restaurant my real card number if I don't have to? Companies don't have to know who you are. Your real credit card number is protected from the data breaches that happen, unfortunately, more often than we would like, and it's completely free. They do have a paid version with different tiers where you can create more virtual credit card numbers per month, cashback rewards, extra security features. But go ahead and sign up for the free service. It's a no-brainer. Companies can't charge you unexpectedly. You're protected from identity theft. It costs you nothing. And Privacy is giving you $5 to spend just for signing up when you go to privacy.com/Pakman.